In the quiet town of Norval, Maine, nestled amidst encroaching pines, I lived in an antiquated Victorian manor. The house, with its peeling paint and moss-encrusted roof tiles, was a haunting silhouette against the forest's dense backdrop. As a writer, I sought isolation, but the house, it offered a form of solitude I hadn't accounted for. The peculiar occurrences began one blustery November night. Shadows moved with an ominous volition, unchained from their sources. Soft whispers brushed past my ears, their chilling touch making my skin erupt in goosebumps. Rationality, my steadfast ally, attributed these eerie phenomena to the wind, the ancient house, and my overactive imagination. Yet, it was the peculiar hourglass that ensnared my attention. An artifact left behind by the previous owner, it sat in my study, filled with glimmering, inky black sand. An ordinary object by day, but when the sun set, it would flip itself, and the black sand would trickle slowly down, defying all laws of nature. Late one night, caught in the thrall of a mystery novel, I noticed the room had grown colder. Looking up, I saw the hourglass flipping itself. Its black sand began its downward journey, and a terrifying chill raced down my spine. The whispers grew louder, morphing into a deafening cacophony. The flickering candlelight revealed creeping shadows inching their way towards me. I was paralyzed, a captive in my own home. In an attempt to reclaim control, I reached for the hourglass. The moment my fingertips brushed its cold brass surface, a rush of gruesome images flooded my mind. The house's past inhabitants meeting horrifying, untimely deaths. Women, men, children, their terrified faces etched in my memory. It was as if the hourglass was the conduit for their tormented spirits. The echoes of their final screams lingered in my mind long after I let go of the hourglass. Each night was a repeated ordeal, a fight against unseen forces. Sleep, when it graced me, was marred with nightmares of blood-streaked walls and ghastly apparitions. My solitary sanctuary became a prison of spectral torment, each day a mere countdown to the inevitable nightly horrors. Feeling my sanity fray at the edges, I enlisted the help of a local priest. He listened, eyes widening, but I could tell he was more afraid for my mental health than any spiritual peril. Nevertheless, he agreed to bless the house, a ritualistic performance that did little to dispel the haunting. The spectral apparitions grew more aggressive, the whispers louder, and the cold more penetrating. My skin bore a constant pallor, mirroring the dread gnawing at my soul. The isolation I once craved was now the bane of my existence. I felt alienated, encased in a shell of terror, forced to face the unseen terrors alone. I considered leaving, yet an inexplicable force tethered me to the manor. Each escape attempt led me right back to its creaking steps. A prisoner in my own home, I was left to bear the brunt of the ceaseless haunting. In the throes of my desperation, I attempted to destroy the hourglass, the genesis of my torment, but it proved invincible. Withstanding hammer, fire, even the grinding wheel, each failed attempt heightened the intensity of the nightly horrors, the house retaliating against my feeble attempts at rebellion. As I pen this tale, the sun dips beneath the horizon, and the familiar chill creeps into my bones. The hourglass flips itself, the first grain of sand heralding the beginning of my nightly ordeal. The whispers have begun, the spectral shadows gather, and I find myself once again on the precipice of terror. My days are spent in the long shadow of fear, my nights in a nightmare I can neither escape nor accept. This is my existence, a horrifying symphony of spectral torment that keeps time with the eerie trickle of the cursed hourglass. The woman who sought solitude in the whispering pines of Norval, Maine, is now a captive in her own ghostly narrative.